what I see is what it could become. Right now we have this basket of fiat currencies. They all float relative to each other since Bretton Woods and the Nixon shock and the adjustment of how they're not pinged to an actual hard asset like gold or otherwise anymore. So they're floating relative to each other, and they each have intrinsic and relative value to one another based upon the balance of payments between those countries. Exporting-driven countries want to have a devalued currency. It makes them more competitive. Importing-driven ones want to have a hard currency or a less diluted currency because it's better for their consumers. So there's always this balance happening.
It's been 115 years since investors had an opportunity like this. The Rockefellers, the Vanderbilts, and Henry Ford made a fortune from the last energy-powered vehicle revolution. Let's seize the moment in the hottest sector in the world right now. Visit crushthestreet.com/win.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into crushthestreet.com. I'm Kenneth Amaduri, and we're covering Bitcoin today. Bitcoin is going mainstream, and people are investing in it, even in their IRAs and 401ks and retirement. And I actually have on the line with me Chris Klein, the COO of Bitcoin IRA, and we're going to go over Bitcoin, the environment that it's in, and where it's going with him. He's an absolute expert on it. And first of all, Chris, thanks for coming on the line with me today.
Thanks for having me, Kenneth. It's a pleasure.
Chris, let's start off with an introduction for yourself. Just kind of let us know how you got interested in Bitcoin, and why are you so excited about it?
It started with just an interest in alternatives to begin with. I was born at the transition of the analog to digital era. Grew up when we knew that the garden hose was okay to drink out of, and that we had the street light that came on at 9 o'clock, knew that we had to go home for dinner otherwise when it got dark. And then grew up into the digital age of understanding a lot of the cycles that take place in economics, and came out of college in 2008, which we all remember wasn't the best time to be looking for jobs or otherwise. And it drove me into understanding what kind of alternatives are there outside of what we think of traditionally as investment vehicles. Really sharpened my teeth, getting into the precious metals world and understanding that there was a high demand as of recent for physical gold and silver, the real thing, and took that understanding of the IRA financial conduit in the self-directed space, and our team here really pushed ourselves to say, what is possible? What are people looking for, and why can't they hold it inside their IRA? Why does it just have to be the stocks, bonds, annuities, and mutual funds that my broker or my 401k offer in simple generic funds?
Well, let's talk about Bitcoin here for a second, where it's going. Obviously, with what you're providing, Bitcoin is going mainstream, and that lends itself to why we're seeing such a high price. I mean, we're talking $900 per Bitcoin right now. It was over 1,000 just a few weeks ago. How significant is this? And, where do you see Bitcoin going here, going forward?
Well, it's kind of been a very exciting time. I don't think we anticipated the adoption at this speed or velocity. We've learned a lot about the enthusiast and the novice and also the expert of Bitcoin, but also the driving desire of anybody looking for something outside of dollar-based assets. I think it's a pretty big deal that we didn't realize how big of a deal it would be, which is an exciting thing to do in business. Sometimes the saying from an old mentor is, if a tree falls in the woods and there's nobody there to hear it, doesn't make a sound. Mm-hmm. When you're evolving and pushing the cliff of innovation, sometimes you don't know if you're in the space that people are looking for. And being validated by the press and mainstream media, like the Wall Street Journal a few weeks ago, being in the weekend edition and the print edition, was pretty mind-boggling to us, because we figured that we would be in the Bitcoin space. We're kind of the alternative group. Those are the guys that are sitting on the other side. But the adoption from buyers that are looking for additional opportunity, but also protection against fiat currency and its debacles ahead, has been really, and just overall, a very exciting time here at Bitcoin IRA.
Chris, one of the things that we've seen and we've documented here at Crush the Street is, the fact that the government and the people in power, I mean, they've gone after threats to the fiat currency, specifically gold and silver, with manipulating the markets, and openly admitting to manipulating the markets, specifically these bullion banks. But I'm wondering, because so many people have gotten into Bitcoin because of the fact that it's anonymous and, you know, it's kind of outside of the system. But a Bitcoin IRA is kind of going into the system. And I just, you know, wanted to kind of get your thoughts on that, you know, kind of your opinion for people who have liked Bitcoin because of the fact that it's anonymous and it's kind of outside of the mainstream infrastructure.
Yeah, absolutely. I compare it a little bit to layers of protection. Anonymous, really anything you do within a IRA, traditional Roth or otherwise, there's really no anonymity to it. It's an IRA account that's held by a custodian that's under your name that bears assets in a tax deferred or some other structured asset class type. So we knew from the beginning that we wouldn't be able to say, oh, this you're going to be 100% privacy and nobody will ever know you have this Bitcoin. Which we were curious, you know, was that the only driving selling point was the anonymity? And what we found is, like you said, it's a alternative to government controlled money. And that's been a real driving dominant buying method for our client base. When we started to see those buyers come in and what their strategies were, we got a better understanding of where their overall sentiments were at. The privacy and anonymity, they understood they had to give that up as far as being inside of an IRA, but security was still very important to them. And security was also very important to the regulators and the IRAs and IRS custodians that allowed us to make this happen through our years of development with them. Security was key, knowing that it wasn't about velocity. This isn't in the Bitcoin IRA space. It isn't about doing multiple trades per day. It's the type of buyer is one that looks down the road 3 to 5 years and sees that there may be turbulence in the stock market, turbulence in the currency market, and just overall unrest about how money is going to be transitioned into the future. And they want to be there and be a part of it now as an early adopter. And that's really what's been driving people. So the privacy component isn't really a hot selling point in the retirement space. Everybody knows that what you have in your IRA is on record. However, the layers of protection come into play when you look at examples in just modern history where you've had overnight in Greece and in Poland, citizens of that country woke up and 5, 6, 7% of their savings accounts, bank accounts or otherwise, had been replaced with government IOUs. That's a real possibility moving forward, especially with this growing debt and what this next administration plans on doing as far as spinning our way out of problems that people are concerned about. And so to take yourself out of zeros and ones, which is digital currency, which is easily controlled and confiscated or nationalized, and putting yourself into a cryptocurrency that doesn't have that leniency. They can't just simply go in and do that, especially in the structure of how we built our Bitcoin IRA. The vault wallets are stored in cold storage off the exchange. The process by which to redeem or subscribe or buy or sell Bitcoin has very very sophisticated and several steps of verification for the security of that Bitcoin, so it just can't disappear with a keystroke. And that's what people are really excited about. That and, of course, the upside potential. We started this. Our first account was in June of last year. Ed Moy, former director of the United States Mint, was our first client. He's also our chief strategist here at Bitcoin IRA. And we were around $400, I think, just over $400 per Bitcoin at that time. And to watch this rise in these 6 months, and many experts from some that you talk about in your guys' site with Webroot and otherwise, there's an overall sentiment that how high will it go, but it's definitely certainly going to go up. When you get more mainstream adoption is where you curb some of that volatility. A shallow trading market in 2013 is why we saw things like the $1,200 run and then the fall back to $200. We didn't see that take place even with the Bitfinex hack and with the recently breaking into a 1,000 territory, and the pullback was a healthy correction back to 900, not something that was catastrophic. And that's all because of more mainstream adoption, more buyers in the marketplace, higher volume trades, so that some institutional group or one single individual can't sell off and short the market as it could 2 or 3 years ago so effectively.
Well, on the regulatory side, you probably have the greatest pulse over most people regarding the authorities and in the sentiment towards Bitcoin. And, you know, I gotta ask you, I mean, how is the sentiment towards from the authorities, from the regulatory agencies towards what you guys are doing in Bitcoin? And do you see it as a potential problem down the line? Do you see them coming after and trying to crack down on Bitcoin here in the future?
Well, from our side, you know, you walk into any room of bankers or regulators and you say the word Bitcoin, and about 90% of them are going to stop listening. So our challenge was to build a process that was relatable to them and other assets that are carried in self-directed retirements. So in a self-directed IRA, there's a custodian that's not as much more passive than your 401k or your traditional IRA stock guy. He's more actively involved in everything. He's got giving you guidance. That's what he's there for. In the self-directed space, it's driven by the user. So what we needed to do was put together a turnkey solution that was a process they could feel comfortable with. At one point in time when we did a presentation, I didn't say the word Bitcoin or the product name until the end of the presentation. And I did that on purpose. I walked through and explained parallels of how a precious metals investment takes place versus how a Bitcoin investment would take place, explain the pros and cons on both sides of that aisle, and actually at the end of the day, it's a much more streamlined and efficient and transparent process on Bitcoin, where the custodians felt even more secure about the asset. And then I was able to tell them that the asset we're discussing using this process is Bitcoin. And that changed the perspective a little bit. If you walk in and you say, I'm a Bitcoin guy, what I noticed in this industry, first and foremost, was the people just de facto to terrorism, money laundering, criminal activity, because that was the MO for the beginning years of it. A lot of the things that we saw over there, even in mainstream movies like the motion picture Dope talked about, using Bitcoin for drug sales. So it was making sure and eliminating those habits and allowing them to realize that there are mainstream middle America, coastal American buyers that are interested in having something alternative in their retirement. So it was all about presentation, and also safety and security were the big things. Moving forward, you know, the people talk about, there's the SEC, the investigation into Coinbase and other groups of wanting to get rid of that anonymity. We're not really worried about that in the IRA space because everything is transparent. Every account has an account holder. They're onboarded with the custodian, which has its protocols from IRS standings. They're also onboarded with the trading liquidity partners for Know Your Customer and here at Bitcoin IRA. So there's nothing hidden or sneaky going on, we prefer that. We want to help drive that towards a more compliant industry. You know, when you get into young, fledgling, adolescent industries, you're going to have good and bad, and we want to be a driving factor towards the mainstream adoption of this. And part of that is transparency. Part of that is communication, and making sure that people understand the usage of this is as an investment vehicle, not as what they automatically de facto think of when they consider Bitcoin.
And then when it comes to volatility, you know, one of the reasons why people have a hard time considering it money is that they don't exactly know where it's going to be in 6 months. If you wanted to put a pool in the back of your house and just save some money for the next 6 months, you know, Bitcoin could be $900, and, you know, realistically, it could be at $600 6 months down the line based on what we've seen and the way it's traded. But I know you talked about it more. It's becoming more mainstream. More people are coming in, higher volumes. But I'd like to ask you a little more. I mean, how much or where do you see it ultimately going and acting? And is it going to be something that is relatively stable here 5 years from now? What do you see the environment ultimately looking like?
I think the first part there's a few questions, but the first part is thinking of this as a more long-term investment vehicle is a smart decision. Most of our buyers are going into this portion that they put in their portfolio for 3 to 5 year holding period so that they can get through any short-term or mid-term volatility that may occur. So they're not taking money from a savings account that they're planning on building a pool with in 6 months. That volatility at this time could be your best friend or your worst enemy. So moving into a long-term setting gives you the ability to curb through that. Long-term, I'm a true believer of Bitcoin. I wasn't when I first started this. I was a lot like a lot of other people. What is that funny money? Is it monopoly money? What does it really mean? When you get the hours behind the wheel and you start really understanding the power of what this disruption technology is going to do over time, it clicks. You have that aha moment. And for me, as I continue to work into the Bitcoin space, what I see is what it could become. Right now we have this basket of fiat currencies. They all float relative to each other since Bretton Woods and the Nixon shock and the adjustment of how they're not pegged to an actual hard asset like gold or otherwise anymore. So they're floating relative to each other, and they each have intrinsic and relative value to one another based upon the balance of payments between those countries. Exporting-driven countries want to have a devalued currency. It makes them more competitive. Importing-driven ones want to have a hard currency or a less diluted currency because it's better for their consumers. So there's always this balance happening. And I foresee a time in the probably more distant future where that basket of fiat currencies may be supplemented or replaced by a basket of cryptocurrencies. Mm. Bitcoin is obviously the leader in the beginning of that pack, but you have Ethereum and you have other altcoins and other coins coming up. And as long as they can find the adoption driven by the utility usage of their coin, which is really what crypto is all about, is can it be secured? Is it finite? And can it be utilized by the common retail user? If those start to come true, then you may have types of cryptocurrency that are for different uses, paying utility bills, paying rent, accepted for mortgage payments, specific ones like that. And that may be the driving force. I don't have a crystal ball, but to me, if we can live in a world of relative currencies like this, and we're kind of realizing that, you know, the dollar is strong right now, but that's only because, as Ed Moy always tells me, it's the cleanest dirty laundry shirt in the dirty laundry hamper. It looks great because all the others are so battered by printing or otherwise. And as those steps continue to move forward and utility takes place, you're going to see, I believe, the volatility start to fall significantly. That's just because more balance of payments are going to be taking place. You know, I was reading something the other day that the amount of money that could be saved by large conglomerate corporations shifting to a Bitcoin monetary system for their merchant services as opposed to fiat is a significant savings. For groups like Walmart or large retailers like that, you're talking in the hundreds of millions of dollars saved per year. More adoption at that large institutional level, and then guys like us having regular buyers wanting to protect their 401ks or IRAs with something new and alternative, combine those two, and it may be a perfect storm for mainstream adoption ahead. Hitting the Wall Street Journal was a big pillar for us in a positive light. You know, a lot of times you see when Bitcoin hits the news, it's because there was a Bitfinex hack, or there may have been this, and sometimes it's ignored altogether. But to be seen as a viable investment vehicle at a time with so much uncertainty of where to put your money, this is a perfect storm for Bitcoin to really take a charge ahead in 17.
Well, what about, and you mentioned alternative currencies. You guys are Bitcoin IRA. What if people wanted to invest in other alternative currencies? Can they do that in their IRA through you guys?
We are adding those now. We're not, you know, there's hundreds of them out there. And you have to be very careful in the ICO or initial currency offering world, because there is a lot of pump and dump schemes, and there's a lot of scams or otherwise out there. It's an unregulated kind of Wild West industry at this point. But what you can do is, as we continue to add them, which Ethereum is likely going to be added to our wallets here in the near future, maybe 17, it might take till 2018. Other investors, we have had clients that have taken, in an IRA sense, you get a 60-day rollover every 12 months. And what that means is you can take your funds out for 60 days, tax and penalty free, and put them into other investments. As long as you return the exact investment in 60 days' time, there will be no taxes or penalties. It's something we're allowed every year. People use it for several different reasons, to bridge bills. Others do it for down payments on homes or escrow, all kinds of reasons why people use them. We had a buyer that actually wanted to get into another coin, and they would only accept Bitcoin to purchase that coin. That's kind of how the cryptocurrency space works. What was really unique about this experience was he's in an IRA, and if he was at any other traditional house, Fidelity, Edward Jones, Wells Fargo, any of them, in fiat currency, and he would call them, like he called me and said, hey, I have about 30 minutes, but I have an opportunity. I'd like to get my Bitcoin out in an in-kind distribution for a 60-day rollover and put it into this other offering. But I have 30 minutes. He would have been laughed off the phone by almost every other company out there in the fiat world, because money just doesn't move that fast. They've got to queue up wires. They've got to verify ACH, whatever it may be. Then it has to go through the wire sphere, and then comes in, and all of a sudden the other bank sees it suddenly. And it's all about time, because that's how they make interest on that time. In the Bitcoin space, it was about 25 minutes. We had about 5 minutes to spare, and we had the Bitcoin private wallet via in-kind distribution for a 60-day rollover. And he laughed because, man, he said, you moved $300,000 worth of money faster than Domino's can make a pizza. That was another one of those moments in time where we realized this is going to be a disruptive technology. If it can make money more efficiently, and we move a lot of money in the IRA space, so we're familiar with the troubles of wires out, paper checks, and transfer rejects. We understand that there's so much cumbersome obstacles to get over in this fiat space of monetary systems. To move money that efficiently, securely, and transparently with Bitcoin is a game changer. And there's going to be more moments like that are going to occur as more and more Bitcoin is adopted. I don't think we've truly seen the extent of the power of this type of currency.
Well, I love it, man. And, you know, I appreciate you guys like you out there really you know, creating, you know, the opportunity and really, you know, pioneering this brand new frontier that has opened up here in the digital currency world. So congratulations to you and your team. If people want to learn more about you guys, you know, and open up an IRA with you, where would they go? And, you know, tell us a little more about it.
Yeah, there's a few ways to get a hold of us. We're on the West Coast here in Sherman Oaks, California. So we're in about 7 a.m. Pacific time until about 5 p.m. Pacific time as well. So for those on the East Coast, have to get out of work or otherwise, or those on the West Coast early before you head to work, or anytime you can drop us a line or a call. Our local number is 818-616-8781. We have Bitcoin specialists and IRA specialists here to help with the transfer of funds, as well as educate on any of the details of how the Bitcoin process works. Easiest way to get a hold of us any time of day or night, and we'll get you the information you're looking for, is at bitcoinira.com. In there, you can submit a form to get some information. We'll send out details about Bitcoin, our investor's guide, and then be there to field questions. And then it's a relatively smooth process. The slowest part is your old custodian or 401k moving funds into position. I wish we could do it instantaneously, but we will have your wallet, account, and all the details necessary completed within the first few hours once we talk and we send out forms for e-signature. What will take some time is, will Edward Jones or Fidelity or the others, how long it takes for them to send the funds over. We're very good at streamlining that and avoiding any delays. As soon as those funds arrive, then you can start building a strategy of when and how you want to enter the marketplace. We have some clients that go all in and just do a single trade, others that do some dollar cost averaging strategies. But overall, it's a seamless process from beginning to end. And you'll see once you get into the Bitcoin space how fast it is. Once all the money and the fiat currency is out of the way, it's instantaneously inside your wallet. It's activated. You become a viewer of that wallet. You can track it over time, see how it's performing, measure it against other assets, and be part of a space that gives you a very empowering mentality. We're used to a boom, bust, boom, follow the stock market guy's advice. You're going to make money, lose money. And there's this empowerment shift that's taking place, and we're happy to be a part of it. I truly love speaking. I've worked with every single one of our clients to date, and I intend on keeping that the case moving forward to learn. There's so much about each of us that we're trying to do innovative. We have ambassadors and affiliates that have come out of the client base, people telling family and friends or otherwise. So it's a community that we're honored to be serving and be a part of.
Well, Chris, hey, it was a pleasure speaking with you today. I really enjoyed this conversation, and I love where Bitcoin is going, and you're one of the few out there that are making it happen, so I applaud you for that. Thanks again for coming on the line with me.
Absolutely, Kenneth. Thanks for having me, and anytime you want to talk about Bitcoin, cryptocurrency, or any alternatives, feel free to reach out to us here at Bitcoin IRA. Was the anonymity. And what we found is, like you said, it's a alternative to government controlled money. And that's been a real driving dominant buying method for our client base. When we started to see those buyers come in and what their strategies were, we got a better understanding of where their overall sentiments were at. The privacy and anonymity, they understood they had to give that up as far as being inside of an IRA, but security was still very important to them. And security was also very important to the regulators and the IRAs and IRS custodians that allowed us to make this happen through our years of development with them. Security was key, knowing that it wasn't about velocity. This isn't in the Bitcoin IRA space. It isn't about doing multiple trades per day. It's the type of buyer is one that looks down the road 3 to 5 years and sees that there may be turbulence in the stock market, turbulence in the currency market, and just overall unrest about how money is going to be transitioned into the future. And they want to be be there and be a part of it now as an early adopter. And that's really what's been driving people. So the privacy component isn't really a hot selling point in the retirement space. Everybody knows that what you have in your IRA is on record. However, the layers of protection come into play when you look at examples in just modern history where you've had overnight in Greece and in Poland, citizens of that country woke up and 5, 6, 7% of their savings accounts, bank accounts or otherwise, had been replaced with government IOUs. That's a real possibility moving forward, annuities and mutual funds that my broker or my 401k offer in simple generic funds.
Well, let's talk about Bitcoin here for a second, where it's going. Obviously, with what you're providing, Bitcoin is going mainstream, and that lends itself to why we're seeing such a high price. I mean, we're talking $900 per Bitcoin right now. It was over 1,000 just a few weeks ago. You know, how significant is this? And, you know, where do you see Bitcoin going here, going forward?
Well, it's kind of been a very exciting time. I don't think we anticipated the adoption at this speed or velocity. We've learned a lot about the enthusiast and the novice and also the expert of Bitcoin, but also the driving desire of anybody looking for something outside of dollar-based assets. I think it's a pretty big deal that we didn't realize how big of a deal it would be, which is an exciting thing to do in business. Sometimes the saying from an old mentor is, if a tree falls in the woods and there's nobody there to hear it, doesn't make a sound. Mm-hmm. When you're evolving and pushing the cliff of innovation, sometimes you don't know if you're in the space that people are looking for. And being validated by the press and mainstream media, like the Wall Street Journal a few weeks ago, being in the weekend edition and the print edition, was pretty mind-boggling to us, because we figured that we would be in the Bitcoin space. We're kind of the alternative group. You know, those are the guys that are sitting on the other side. But the adoption from buyers that are looking for additional opportunity, but also protection against... What I see is what it could become. Right now we have this basket of fiat currencies. They all float relative to each other since Bretton Woods and the Nixon shock and the adjustment of how they're not pinged to an actual hard asset like gold or otherwise anymore. So they're floating relative to each other, and they each have intrinsic and relative value to one another based upon the balance of payments between those countries. Exporting-driven countries want to have a devalued currency. It makes them more competitive. Importing-driven ones want to have a hard currency or a less diluted currency because it's better for their consumers. So there's always this balance happening.
It's been 115 years since investors had an opportunity like this. The Rockefellers, the Vanderbilts, and Henry Ford made a fortune from the last energy-powered vehicle revolution. Let's seize the moment in the hottest sector in the world right now. Visit crushthestreet.com/win.
Hello, everyone, and welcome into crushthestreet.com. I'm Kenneth Amaduri, and we're covering Bitcoin today. Bitcoin is going mainstream, and people are investing in it, even in their IRAs and, you know, 401ks and retirement. And I actually have on the line with me Chris Klein, the COO.
Fiat currency and its debacles ahead has been really... And just overall, a very exciting time here at Bitcoin IRA.
Chris, you know, one of the things that we've seen and we've documented here at Crush the Street is, you know, the fact that the government and the people in power, I mean, they've gone after threats to the fiat currency, you know, specifically gold and silver, with manipulating the markets, you know, and openly admitting to manipulating the markets, specifically these bullion banks. But I'm wondering, because so many people have gotten into Bitcoin because of the fact that it's anonymous and, you know, it's kind of outside of the system. But a Bitcoin IRA is kind of going into the system. And I just, you know, wanted to kind of get your thoughts on that, you know, kind of your opinion for people who have liked Bitcoin because of the fact that it's anonymous and it's kind of outside of the mainstream infrastructure.
Yeah, absolutely. I compare it a little bit to layers of protection. Anonymous, really anything you do within a IRA, traditional Roth or otherwise, there's really no anonymity to it. It's an IRA account that's held by a custodian that's under your name that bears assets in a tax-deferred or some other structured asset class type. So we knew from the beginning that we wouldn't be able to say, oh, this you're going to be 100% privacy and nobody will ever know you have this Bitcoin. Which we were curious, you know, was that the only driving selling point
of Bitcoin IRA? And we're going to go over, you know, Bitcoin, the environment that it's in, and where it's going with him. He's an absolute expert on it. And first of all, Chris, thanks for coming on the line with me today.
Thanks for having me, Kenneth. It's a pleasure.
Chris, let's start off with, you know, an introduction for yourself. Just kind of let us know how you got interested in Bitcoin and, you know, why are you so excited about it?
I started with just an interest in alternatives to begin with. I was born at the transition of the analog to digital era. You know, grew up when we knew that the garden hose was okay to drink out of and that we had a street light that came on at 9 o'clock, knew that we had to go home for dinner otherwise when it got dark. And then grew up into the digital age of understanding a lot of the cycles that take place in economics. And came out of college in 2008, which we all remember wasn't the best time to be looking for jobs or otherwise. And it drove me into understanding what kind of alternatives are there outside of what we think of traditionally as investment vehicles. Really sharpened my teeth, getting into the precious metals world and understanding that there was a high demand as of recent for physical gold and silver, the real thing, and took that understanding of the IRA financial conduit in the self-directed space, and our team here really pushed ourselves to say, what is possible? What are people looking for, and why can't they hold it inside their IRA? Why does it just have to be the stocks, bonds,